Haitian police say these men, paraded out for the press, were the ones who carried out an attack that killed Haitian President Jovenel Moise and wounded his wife. The suspects, 18 Colombian men, most of them former soldiers, and two Americans of Haitian descent. But now authorities say they have the mastermind, blaming a Florida doctor, saying he flew into the country on a private jet, intent on taking over the presidency. American investigators from the FBI and Homeland Security are believed to be taking part in the investigation now. But as for Haiti's request for U.S. troops, it seems unlikely.
And today, an interagency team, largely from Department of Homeland Security and the FBI, are heading down to Haiti right now to see what we can do to help them in the investigative process. And I think that's really where our energies are best applied right now, in helping them get their arms around investigating this incident and figuring out who's culpable, who's responsible, and how best to hold them accountable going forward. That's where our focus is right now.
There are reports that armed gangs have, in essence, taken over their violent crimes unchecked by police.
In certain places, we see one or two police officers, but they don't have the capacity to take over security. There are not enough police. The Director General of the National Police said there are enough police for the capital, but I don't see them. We can see one here, one there.
And now one of Haiti's most powerful gang leaders is threatening more violence.
We will take to the streets to ask those who monopolize the country's economy to give us our country back. It's time for black people with Afro hair like us to own supermarkets, to have car dealerships and own banks. I call on the attention of the masters of the system, because the people will take to the streets. The last time the people came out, they threw tear gas. When the people come out, we are going to use self-defense. I repeat, if they shoot at us, we already know what we have to do.
Many Haitians have been hiding in their homes, but some look for sanctuary in their churches Sunday, while Pope Francis sent them public prayers.
I join the heartfelt appeal of the bishops of the country to drop the weapons and choose life, and choose to live together in brotherhood in the interest of everybody and in the interest of all the others. I'm close to the beloved people of Haiti. I hope the spiral of violence will end and the nation will be able to recover the path towards a future of peace and harmony.
And still, there is a political void as politicians fight over who will lead next. Patty Culhane, Al Jazeera, Washington.